This video is solving problems using proportional parts number 3. So first off, we need to solve for x, and it's kind of strange since we've got a full side length 3x minus 2. Well, that shouldn't be too big a problem because we've got 3 and 5. So we can compare proportional parts by adding 3 and 5 together. And so then we'll just cross multiply to solve. So we get x equals 6. Now let's take a look at one more problem. So here we have segment ER is the mid-segment of this triangle. Now remember, mid-segment means three things for us. One thing it means is that point E is the midpoint of segment NH. And so that means these segments are congruent. And likewise, point R is the midpoint of NY. So these lengths are congruent as well. A couple other things. The mid-segment is parallel to its opposite side. And also it creates a couple of pairs of congruent angles. This angle is congruent to this angle because they're corresponding angles cut by a transversal with parallel lines. And then also this angle is congruent to that angle. Now the problem asks us to solve for x. So x refers to side lengths, in particular side lengths nr and ry. Now because er is a mid-segment, I know that those side lengths must be equal. And so we have a couple of terms with an x squared. We have a term with a regular old x, and we have a term with a constant number. So it looks like we're going to have to do some solve by factoring. So let's go through a cleanup session. Let's bring that x squared, 2x squared, over to the other side by subtracting 2x squared from both sides. And then again, since we want to solve by factoring, we'll have to do the same with 7x. And so now we're looking for factors of 12, which add to negative 7. Well, factors of 12, it's either 2 and 6, or 3 and 4. So negative 3 and 4 will do the trick. We have x minus 3 times the quantity x minus 4 equals 0. So now either the first term is equal to 0, or the second term is equal to 0. So if x minus 3 is equal to 0, that means x could possibly be positive 3. If x minus 4 equals 0, that means x could equal positive 4. So now we have two potential answers. Let's just go through and make sure that the side lengths make sense geometrically as well as, geometrically as well as algebraically. So I'll take this value of x, maybe I'll try x equals 3 first, and I'll substitute it in for the values of 3x squared plus 12 and 2x squared plus 7x. Both of those end up being 39. So I know that x minus 3 is a possible answer. Let's check x equals 4 as well. Both of those make that length 60. Now, since both of these sides are positive, it is possible that x is both either 3 or 4. So we have two answers in this case, 3 or 4. Thanks for watching.